Hey guys, so it is Thursday, November 10th, and I am about to drop my brother off at school, and then I am heading to the airport to go to New York. Okay, so let me tell you about this little problem. Me and Megan both are still waiting on packages that we need with us to go to New York, because some of our clothes or whatever. So yeah, that's the dilemma. I'm supposed to get here today, but we don't know what time is getting here today. And our flight is at 11 o'clock. So hopefully the place where my thing gets my package at 9 o'clock when they open, so that I can swing by. Jeremiah, let's go. Swing by there to pick up my package before I head to the airport, because it's all in the same area. Megan just said she's just going to meet me at the airport to wait and see. She get her package. So yeah, I'm gonna show you guys more once I get to the airport and stuff like that. So yeah, bye bye. Hey guys, so Megan's here finally. We're getting ready to head on to the plane. We already checked our bags and stuff, but Megan forgot her coat. So we're waiting on her mom to drop it off. Then we heading back in to head on the plane. I'm so excited, y'all. This is gonna be a much needed vacay, but it's also a business trip. So it's a fun time and party. So yeah. I'm gonna hit y'all back when we get more into the thing. Okay guys, we finally landed in New York City. We're currently having technical difficulties trying to get to our hotel. We're supposed to do Uber. When I tell y'all, Uber prices out here is high as hell. And it's like an hour wait just for it to get to us. So therefore, we're just gonna taxi it up, you know? So we have no other options besides riding on the tram. But we don't know how to use that, so yeah, now we're just waiting. There's like a legit line for a taxi, so I'll let y'all know about that. Hey guys, so fun. We finally got in a taxi or whatever, y'all, because it was just so chaotic. But now we're finally heading to our hotel. I had to throw my head in the ponytail because it was looking a mess. I was looking like, who did it and why? I don't know why I'm so giggly, but yeah.
My phone died.
Making phone keep dying. My camera about to die, y'all. I'm stuck in traffic, though. Our hotel. Now we're walking around. As you can see, we are about to go find something to get something to eat. Oh, let's go to Starbucks. I need something to warm me up. We're gonna find something to eat on the car and go about. So yeah.
single thing you do. You doubted me. Even told me I would never get with you. Told me I could never get with you. But this pride in me wouldn't let you slide by me. That's when I came back round. I played my game with no respect. I finessed you to make me seem down. But I finessed you, was all a stressor. I was your nigga messed up. Fucked your head up, should've never came round. You let me in and I let you down. I was wrong cause I fought up the game, baby. Your name crazy in the streets, got them saying thanks. My pride was the cause of it all.
Thank you.
next to me. Maybe we can start a family. Sorry, we can plan it to the tears. Who doing to me right now? Cause it's so bad the way that it feels. I'm on to you right now. Showing you that this shit is real. I need a girl. Oh yeah. Someone that know this shit is real. Yeah, I need a girl.
Hey guys, so I am ready for the pre-law conference today. Yeah, I'm trying not to get Megan in there because she's not ready. But yeah, about to head to this pre-law conference. I'm ready. Black dress, gray coat. I don't know what I'm looking. But yeah, I'm trying to figure out if I'm going to get on the subway or just going to Uber it. I mean, lift it out. I think I'm gonna lift it because I ain't trying to get stuck. I might do a subway back because I got more time to spare. Right now I got the time because I got to be there at 9 o'clock. So therefore, I'm going to talk to you guys later. Actually, when I get there and show y'all around. So keep tuning in. Hey guys, so let me tell y'all, I'm supposed to be taking the subway to get to the conference. I missed the train because I didn't know like what to do or where to go. So yeah, missed the train, hoping that it had even come back real soon or else it was going to be smooth. And I don't know what to stop to get off of. This is about to be something. Successfully made it off of the subway, you guys, by myself. Now I'm only like 11 minutes away from NYU Law School, where I'm going for this conference. So yeah, I guess I'm like downtown area. I'm not really sure what part of New York. I'm still in New York. But I just don't know like what part. I think it's downtown area because I had to take the downtown sub way to get here. So, and then once I'm supposed to make a left onto Broadway. Yeah, I'm good with the directions. Yeah, the lady, okay, this is how I successfully made it off of the subway. So the lady printed out directions for me or whatever, but she told me like which subway to take, and she was like, it's gonna be 10 stops. So every time we stopped, I counted every stop. Counting until I got to my 10th stop and got on. And I'm at the right place. So yeah, that's how that went. But yeah, let me focus on walking and watching my surroundings and I'm gonna hit y'all back. Okay guys, so it's break time. I'm vlogging. It's break time. So it's break time. We just finished listening to different speakers or whatever. Oh, it was really good. I'm kind of excited, y'all. I think I want to apply to NYU football school now, but I don't know. We're about to go to lunch, so I'm just going to, I can't show y'all the things. It's kind of rude to record while they're speaking, so I'm just going to talk between it. We're about to go on lunch, and I'll catch you guys later.
Y'all
want to
do that again?
Yeah. Well, people are leaving out, so it's not that many people. So this is good. Okay, you guys, I'm gonna show y'all how official it is. Courtney Brown, future lawyer. Just like, oh, I have a YouTube channel, so.
Do you really?
Yeah. So I've been watching. Okay, so this is the building. We're upstairs, NYU. Let me introduce y'all to everybody. This is Aaron Drake.
Selma, Alabama.
Let them know. Do y'all want to introduce yourselves to my camera?
What do I have to say?
Who you are?
I'm Michelin. Hi.
Hi, I'm Sierra.
Sorry. And we all go to UA. Oh, okay.
Wait, I want to know how that looks too. Like,
what's up, y'all? I'm Aaron Drake. Nope, gotta do that. All right.
This is a line to go in there. So we're in line right now.
We don't all need to get out of line.
Lunch is like pizza and drinks and stuff like that. So,
hey, what's your name?
Veronica.
Drake.
Leading one of our historic civil rights organizations, and it was kind of a dream job, a dream gig. I started in January, and what a moment to step into this role. One of the most important things that we do is work to safeguard access to the ballot box, and that work has kept us on our toes all year long throughout our country for the last 3 years in particular. In 2013, the Supreme Court issued a ruling that gut a core provision of one of our nation's most important federal civil rights laws, the Voting Rights Act of 1965. So they
got us, and were created to be used against us in a way that it actually happened.
Come on, Mike.
And so that means that I understand the law with a great deal of skepticism, and I understand my privilege with a great deal of skepticism as well. And so I want to speak from that place, and I think I had a plan about talking about how I came to the law, talking about how incredibly difficult but essential law school was, and then how I now take my leadership from the folks who are in the street, from the people who are most impacted by these systems, and I try to be in service of those people. But because of the last week, and I have to say that I was, I think, unnecessarily shocked by Tuesday's election. And I say shocked, I wasn't necessarily surprised, because I think for the last 3 years I've been in a movement that every day is standing up to incredible and violent white supremacy, that every day people are putting their bodies on the streets, whether it's inside of our prisons. Well, today there is the longest prison strike there has been across the South. The Free Alabama movement is in our prisons refusing to engage in slave labor. I've seen people in Baltimore, in St. Louis. I had the privilege of being in all those prisons.
Okay, guys, I'm just now leaving out of the meeting, the conference. I'm heading back to my hotel so that I can go home and change. We're supposed to be going out tonight. Here's some NYU right here. Different food trucks.
Yes, that is where we need to be.
And I do this on the hill.
So I'm supposed to be trying to find Broadway. I'm about to start. I don't know where Broadway is. I'm about to get high dove, I think. Hi, can I get a high dove? I'm gonna tell you later. Hey y'all, so we currently been sitting up in Macy's. Like, we've been shopping all day in Times Square or whatever. But now we sitting up in Macy's trying to figure out what we about to do. Like, I don't know. To be honest, like, I don't know. We all just good. Everybody tired. Our feet hurt. So, I don't know. But yeah. dope. There's, ooh. I just filmed that lady. So yes. I guess I'm gonna try and film tonight if we go out. Like, I don't know what we're doing, so once I figure that out, I'm gonna let y'all know.
Can we find out what I say?
You just introduced.
Thank you,
what we doing?
Party.
Thank you.
Nothing
to do. So let me tell y'all, we made it to a hookah spot or whatever. We're about to celebrate Megan's birthday because we both know we're birthday babies. So we all up in here, VIP section of the hookah spot. This is everybody. And we're about to get it popping in a little bit. Drinks.
Love this.
100. I see no fucking limits. Shout out to Uncle Luke. Shout out my bitches too. And we the two life crew. Two for me, two for you. Defeat them bitches, parents. Fuck them like a rabbit. Sorry, that's not happening. So flipping and I ran.
This is the place that we just came out of. It's so lit, y'all. Corner Social.
Corner social.
All these people is black people. So we. These are cute little houses. I mean, kind of.
Stop fucking playing.
That's what I'm trying to vlog, and you person, like
a thing. Oh, she vlogging? Put me on the vlog. Shout out to the Magnolia. Shout out to the Calio. So where I'm from, you heard me. Third War.
Boy, hi. How house just open like this?
I'm calling my friends to meet you. Come on. Friends, come in.
Friends, I'm so sorry about that.
Hey. I'm wild. Let me meet you.
Oh, my
gosh. Hey, guys. So I am back at the hotel. After the ceremony was over for, like, the pinning, for all the pre-law students, I end up leaving, coming back to the hotel, changing to get dressed, and end up meeting everybody at Dave & Buster's. I didn't take my camera with me just because I wasn't bringing my bag with me and I didn't want to have to carry my camera around and end up sitting it down and losing it. So therefore, I really didn't get a chance to vlog tonight. So yeah, currently back in the hotel, still kind of early a little bit. So they had this pre-law social whatever going on tonight at a bar, and I'm conflicted on whether or not I want to go. It's pretty cold right now, and our heater isn't warming me up, so I'm not really sure. But yeah, sadly we leave tomorrow. I'm not ready to go because once I get back to leave from here, I gotta go back to reality. Girl, not ready for that shit right now, so I'm sad. I'm probably gonna wake up at 5 o'clock in the morning so that I can do last minute sightseeing. Flight's not till 3, so. Hey guys, so it is Sunday. It is our last day in New York. I'm a little sad right now because I'm not ready to go back to school. But anyways, we are about to go do a little sightseeing before our flight at 3 o'clock. So right now we're heading to the subway to go to Grand Central because I want to see the station, take pictures and all of that. So, straight. We're gonna cross the street. So we made it off of the subway. Now we just have to find out how to get on top. Oh, this way, I think. I'm trying to. Okay, so we finally made it to Grand Central. I'm trying to see how we get to the top here because I want to go in the big part. Hopefully this is it. Not sure. Just following these people. Ah, we made it. Perfect.
Yeah, well, some of it.
But this is
mm-hmm. Okay, so y'all, ever since I used to watch Home Alone, Polar Express, all those type of movies where they show Grand Central, I always wanted to see it. And every time I came to New York, I've never, ever once had an experience, experience of seeing it. So here we go. Ooh, that's pretty. Up there. You were so perfect in my thing.
Oh, send it. I mean, save it.
Okay. Just woke up from a nap, but while we were out, my camera ended up messing up, so I couldn't get everything that was saying. Okay, my camera was doing some buku stupid stuff while we was out, so therefore I didn't get to record everything we were sightseeing. But now we are about to check out of the hotel and head to the stupid ass airport. I am not ready to go. I'm gonna tell you that now. I ain't ready to go. I'm trying to stay out here forever, but whatever. Gotta go back to reality. So, yep, I got a lot. Ooh, crap. Damn, forgot they had a water bottle.